Hey babes, it's Sharonda Isadora and welcome to Brazen Bay Reviews. And during this video, I will be doing a book recap. Let's get to this thing, shall we? All right, thank you so much for joining me. I'm gonna make this quick, short, and to the point. The book we'll be talking about, let me put on my glasses so my ass may see. The book we're talking about today is Natalie Tan's Book of Luck and Fortune. And here is the cover from Goodreads. I'll also insert it somewhere in here so that you can see it. And let's get to this blurb and then I'll tell you my thoughts of this book. All right, so your blurb reads as, directly from Goodreads, lush and visual, chock full of delicious recipes, Roselle Lim's magical debut novel is about food, heritage, and finding family in the most unexpected places. At the news of her mother's death, Natalie Tan returns home. The two women hadn't spoken since Natalie left in anger 7 years ago, when her mother refused to support her chosen career as a chef. Natalie is shocked to discover the vibrant neighborhood of San Francisco's Chinatown that she remembers from her childhood is fading. With businesses failing and families moving out, and she's even more surprised to learn that she's inherited her grandmother's restaurant. The neighborhood seer reads the restaurant's fortune in the leaves. Natalie must cook three recipes from her grandmother's cookbook to aid struggling neighbors before the restaurant will succeed. Unfortunately, Natalie has no desire to help them try to turn things around. She resents the local shopkeepers for leaving her alone to take care of her agoraphobic mother when she was growing up. But when the support of a surprising new friend and a budding romance, Natalie starts to realize that maybe her neighbors really have been there all along. All right, so this is your blurb for Natalie Tan's Book of Luck and Fortune. I requested this book through NetGalley. As you can see, I was approved. I rated this one. Why can't I get my words together here? I rated this one 3.5 stars. Well, you know, Goodreads, they don't let you do half stars. So I rated a good 3 stars. It shows as 3 stars on Goodreads, but I'm giving it more of a 3.5. So from that blurb, you see that Natalie hasn't been home in 7 years. Her and her mom has like this estranged relationship. She hasn't spoken to her mom in 7 years. So with the unexpected death of her mom, she has to return home to this, to this little neighborhood in Chinatown, San Francisco's Chinatown. Natalie has some issues with the people that are still left in the neighborhood. She, like the blurb says, she felt like because her mother had this condition where she couldn't go outside, couldn't leave the house, it was put upon Natalie growing up as a child to take care of her mother during this this illness that her mom had. So Natalie kind of like resented her neighbors because she felt like the neighbors, because this is described in the book as a close-knit neighborhood, that they should have been assisting and taking care of her, which I agree, you know, because she was a child at the time, but you know, it is what it is. But you know, she felt like they should have been there more for her mom. But as Natalie returns home and she starts to find out more information about her mother and her relationship, her mother's relationship, not just with the neighbors in this neighborhood, but with her grandmother as well. Natalie's grandmother died before she was born, so she never knew her grandmother. Natalie and her mom had kind of like this tension-filled relationship, because the same things that Natalie's grandmother put upon her mother. She wanted her mother to, she wanted, Natalie's grandmother wanted Natalie's mom to take over the restaurant when she, you know, take over the family business when she was no longer there. Natalie's mom didn't want to do it. So when Natalie was growing up, when she had this inkling to cook, to be this chef, her mother kind of like fought her on it. So it was kind of like, you know, what Natalie's grandmother wanted for her mom and her mom didn't want, she kind of like, you know, put those things on upon Natalie, and this turned into them having like this very tension filled and stressful relationship. And this caused Natalie to leave home to pursue her career as a chef. She wanted to prove, you know, her mom, prove to her mom that she can be the successful chef. But what ends up happening is, because Natalie had so much anger and resentment towards her mom, while she was out in the world traveling, she did go to culinary school, but she ended up flunking out. But instead of her trying again, she just decided to travel the world, you know, around the world or whatever, and just learn, like, you know, street cooking. But Natalie always have had the knack for cooking. She has always, you know, had this thing in her to cook. So she I thought I saw something pop up on my screen. But she you know, she's just one of those people. She just always knew how to cook, so she always had that going for her. But again, because Natalie has like a whole lot of self-doubt about herself. She doesn't believe that she is worthy of being this world-renowned chef. Even though as we go throughout this book and we hear about her cooking, you know, her cooking for people and stuff, and people are tasting her food and people are loving her food, she still has like this whole lot of self-doubt going on within her. She is just one of those people, like I said, that does not believe that she is worthy of things. She never believed that she was worthy of becoming this very good world-renowned chef. She doesn't believe that she's worthy of love because she had like these failed relationships while she was traveling the world or whatever. But basically, the meat and bones of this story, in my opinion, was Natalie coming back to this neighborhood and finding her grandmother's cookbook. And this is where like the magical realism parts of the story come inside of, because Natalie's grandmother's cookbook kind of has like these recipes that the grandmother has always cooked, has always brought people together. People were having like problems within their relationships, marriage, problems with their business or whatever. Her grandmother's recipes and restaurant was kind of like the focal point of this neighborhood. And when the grandmother died and Natalie's mom refused to open a restaurant up, you know, again, this is where the people in the neighborhood always felt like the businesses around started failing. You know, people started losing their business and stuff. And then they have the onslaught of gentrification coming in. And they have like this realtor that is going around the neighborhood trying to snatch up properties, you know, from these failing businesses and owners and stuff like that, trying to get them to sell. Some people are, but what I liked about the neighborhood and about the people in the neighborhoods, like these old Chinese people, is that they were very gung-ho on not selling their properties. Like, these businesses were in their families for generations and generations, and they just didn't want to sell. No matter if their business was about to fall to the ground or not, they just didn't want to sell. So I thought that was really an interesting thing. But you can really, like, as I read like more and more books, I see like especially from Black authors and other authors of color, you really see like this main theme of gentrification going on within the books, especially like in towns, like in cities where you have like Chinatowns and, you know, what, you know, you know, what people used to call like the ghetto, you know, or the bad neighborhoods. Now you see like all these, you know, fancy apartment buildings and, you know, very expensive apartment units that are going up left and right. So I find that kind of like very interesting that we are starting to see like a lot of Black authors and a lot of other authors of color are starting to put this in their books now, how this gentrification thing is just coming up and up, and they're really like preying on, you know, especially like in this book particular, especially when you have like neighborhoods that are really like struggling, you have like these buildings and these people that have owned these properties that have been in their families for generations, but you know, they can't keep up with the times and stuff like that. You know, you just really have like these realtors and these businesses just coming in and kind of like preying on these people, you know, just offering them, you know, put it like a million on something, and you know, people are ready to sell. So I just think that was an interesting thing. But I will say what drew me most to the story is Natalie's interaction with these neighbors, and there were just particular neighbors in the book that we heard, you know, that we knew about, that these three neighbors that she had to cook for, that were having, you know, everybody was having these problems in the neighborhood, but you know, these particular ones is the one, are the ones that Natalie decided to take on and cook for. That's what I loved most about the book. I just loved her interaction with these neighbors and her cooking these meals and trying to fix the issues that, you know, her neighbors are having and trying to save this neighborhood. Because once she comes in, because she really doesn't like feel a certain kind of way when she initially comes in, her thing was to come in, you know, bury her mother, you know, settle her mother's affairs, possibly sell the building because her grandmother's restaurant was below the apartment her and her mom, you know, she grew up in with her mom, you know. But once she got back in the neighborhood and she started running into the people that she grew up around and stuff, and like I said, once she found out like the real relationship between her grandmother and these neighbors, she started to feel like she had to stay to save these neighbors. So that to me was the draw of the story, just her cooking these meals and you know, trying to fix the relationships of her neighbors, and just, you know, just trying to find a way to save this neighborhood from this onslaught of gentrification that was coming in. We do have a bit of a romance in the story, but I kind of felt like, in my opinion, I just kind of felt like the romance was kind of like thrown in there to give Natalie something else to do throughout the story besides helping her neighbors, you know, save their businesses in this neighborhood or whatever. I just felt like the romance was kind of like rushed. I kind of didn't feel like a connection between her and Daniel initially. I'm all for, you know, love at first sight, or, you know, falling in love with someone and stuff like that. Like, I'm a romantic at heart, but I just didn't feel like a connection between Natalie and Daniel. It was just like, you know, he was drawn to a restaurant because one day she went down there, you know, once she discovered the restaurant was still fully capable of being used, her grandmother's restaurant was fully capable of being used, and she started cooking. He was just kind of like drawn there by the smell of her cooking or whatever. And you know, it's just like they went on one date and they were just like in love, you know, they were just about to have this relationship, and I was just like, no. You know what I mean? So I just felt like the romance was kind of like just thrown in there, you know, just something added extra to give Natalie something to do, extra to do as she tries to work these relationships throughout the story with these neighbors and save this neighborhood. She does run into some issues because Natalie had this really negative way of thinking about herself. Things start to look up and she starts to believe that these recipes are working. Then it kind of like everything starts to fall apart and she has to like discover what is the missing, you know, what is the missing link from her grandmother's recipe book, that, you know, where whatever she did to try to help these three, you know, neighbors in the, you know, in their neighborhood, what could, you know, what could she fix to get everything back to normal? Like I said, for the most part, I enjoyed the story. I rated it 3.5. I'm giving it 3.5 stars. But, you know, it was kind of like a slow build through everything. The best parts of the book, like I said, was Natalie and her relationship with these neighbors and the recipes that were throughout the story as well. But I kind of like felt like the pacing was kind of like, you know, everything outside of the romance in the story was really, really had like a really slow pace. And I wasn't really mad at that because it gave us a chance to get to know Natalie and, you know, the people in her neighborhood and stuff like that. But it did kind of like, you know, the pacing of the story was kind of slow. It did kind of like move slow. You know what I mean? But, you know, that's what it is. But you know, it's a good story. If you love like family dramas and sagas, I think you'll love Natalie Tan's Book of Luck and Fortune. And just, you know, having this young woman come back after 7 years, after having no relationship with her mother, and just her, like, through this cookbook, through her grandmother's recipes, and her learning how to, you know, learning the recipes and cooking for her neighbors and cooking for herself, and this new love that's about to come in her life. You just get to see like this reconnection to her mom and the grandmother she never knew. Like that was a strong point of the story as well. Like even though these figures weren't in her life anymore, through her cooking and through that notebook, she really got to know both her mom and her grandmother in a really different kind of a way. So again, I think it's a very good family drama. A little, you know, like I said, slow pacing, romance was a little bit rushed or whatever, but for the most part, Natalie Tan's Book of Luck and Fortune is a really good read, and I say add it to your library. I mean, your TBR list, reading list, whatever. So that is it for me, and until the next one, guys, later days.